So remember the other day when I said it was an interesting choice to start the daily vlog like this weekend, because this weekend was super busy and it was, man, I am exhausted. Coffee today. Just running on like 2.5 hours of sleep, as you saw, but I'm feeling great. I'm really excited to be back at the church today. It's gonna be a good day. Well, I wrapped up a great morning at the church. The morning starts like you saw, 4:45-ish. I get up, Starbucks 5:30 to 6:45, then 7 to 7:30. I set up at the church, get ready for the other team members to get there. 7:30 to 8:15 we rehearse. 8:15 to 8:45 we have like a devotional downstairs before we lead, and then we have a 9 o'clock service, a 10:45 service. So I don't really vlog any of that kind of stuff. I just choose to kind of keep that side of it just private with the team. Love to share life with them and just do life together, but so I don't really bring camera into those situations. So typically on a Sunday I can probably guarantee you'll just really see like a time lapse of the service, maybe, but for the most part, yeah. Hi, honey. Gracie, come. It's like a dog. Gracie, come.
Come on.
Good girl. All right. Well, back to the church. Thanks. See, this weekend was great. The problem is when you do daily vlogs, if your entire day is wrapped up in one specific thing, like I had a wedding all day Friday and a wedding all day Saturday and then basically church for the majority of the day. But I figured today would be a good opportunity because there's been a lot of recent new subscribers on this channel that I could just basically really briefly, as quick as possible, tell you a little bit about who I actually am, because I know the majority of you that watch this YouTube, and there's been a lot of subscribers lately that have been coming to this channel, which I'm extremely thankful for. And I love this community of people, and I want you to get to know me more, and I want to get to know you more, because I love community. I love getting to know who's talking, what you do, how you got to where you are. I'm really, really passionate about learning how people got to where they are today, whether good or bad. We've all been on a journey. We are all getting somewhere, or we are going somewhere, and I love to know what your story is. So from the time that I was 18 years old, basically a senior in high school, all the way till about 27 or 28 years old, I played music full time. It was my entire profession. I traveled around the country, which I talked about in my daily vlog, but I traveled all over the country. I did music festivals, I did colleges, I did bars, I did a little bit of everything. That was my profession for the majority of almost 10 years, and I absolutely loved it and played as many gigs as possible, played over 1,000 shows. And I don't say that to flaunt, I say that to help you understand the next part of this story, which is the fact that as I started to do that, I kind of constantly started to realize more and more that I was just not really enjoying music anymore, and I was kind of tired of pursuing my own self goals and my own self-worth and my own just what am I doing with myself. And while I loved the opportunity to travel, I knew it was obviously time to eventually to start a family and to just kind of put aside the, you know, quote unquote goal of being a rock star that everybody has when they are younger. And I had always grown up in the church, and I always really enjoyed playing music in the church. I actually learned how to play guitar from the worship team in my church, so people around me helped me learn, and that's how I learned how to play music at all. I literally went to every single rehearsal when I wasn't even on a weekend, and gracious, kind people helped me learn how to play guitar, which was just awesome. And that's literally one of the reasons why I do as much as I can now to provide value to other people, because people poured into me when I was young and helped me grow to where I'm at today. And so I'm always appreciative, and I'm always striving to do the same thing for somebody else in some way. In 2008, I met my wife in Brookings, Oregon at a random music event that I was traveling around the country. I met her, and they, you know, the cliche thing is the rest is history, but it was. And next year, 2009, we got married in October. And then October 2010, we moved to Phoenix, Arizona. We lived there for about 3 years, and I became really passionate about doing worship music, specifically the church and playing and leading worship. And it was something that I really, really felt called to, and I really just loved doing it. And then in 2013, we moved from Phoenix, Arizona back to Allentown, Pennsylvania, which is where we now live, which I realize I really haven't talked about even where I live, but I live in Allentown, Pennsylvania. It's a great place, about an hour and a half north of Philadelphia and west of New York City. I'm so bad with geography, but it's a great place. But I came back here for the opportunity to lead worship at a church, and it was a really awesome opportunity that I am so, so thankful for, and I love the fact that I get to do that. And for the last 3 years, that's what I've done full time. And then I kind of just felt this natural feeling you get when you have a child and you have another one on the way, which is simply that you need to put your family over your job. And if your job doesn't allow you to really be the husband or be the father or be whatever it is to be, then you can kind of get yourself in trouble. And so my wife and I, after really, really talking about it and thinking about it like crazy, we decided it was just best for me to leave full-time ministry at the church and just go into my business full-time. And it was awesome to see opportunities open in that way, and we just felt this great peace that it was what we were supposed to do, which was go and pursue full-time 4LC Studios work. And since then, it's just been an awesome, awesome opportunity. As I was at the church for 3 years, I realized that I was doing all I could to minister really well to the people in the church, but not really doing a great job being a husband and being there, because I worked 40 hours a week at the church, and then I also worked like another 40 hours a week for my business, and it just was not a healthy lifestyle, and it wasn't something that I want to do. But that brings us to today, which is 2017, and I'm just going through this journey of life and just really, really loving what's happening right now in life. Life is so good. I got another child on the way. Job is good. Friends are good. Life is just awesome, and I'm just super grateful for it. But I appreciate you being here and just being a part of this journey. That's like kind of my story in a nutshell. But I just want to get to know you more, and I would love to learn more about your journey. I would love to hear where you're from, hear what kind of things you're into. Just comment below. This is all for conversation's sake. I hope that you never get the impression that I'm doing a daily vlog because I want more and more people to see me. I want to provide value to you. You're going to hear me say that all the time, but my goal in this is to provide value in some way. Everyone's inspired by different things, and this vlog may be something different for you. It may be to learn tech. It may be to just learn how to grow. I don't know what it is. I'm just going to try my best to keep uploading and helping you in some way. But let's keep this conversation going. It's the reason I'm doing this, and I hope you enjoy it. Sorry if this was kind of like a long rant. That's my sister. That's my sister, Emily.
I'm going to do it.
See ya. Good job.
Good to see you.
God bless you. Have a good day.
Hi, puppy. Hi, pretty girl. Without a doubt, one of the craziest and most exciting time in our life was a part that I completely forgot to tell you about. So in 2010, we were in Arizona, and I, being a dreamer and being someone that wants to travel, wants to do a lot, I thought it would be a great idea to buy that. This was our home. So from 2011 to 2013, until about a year after we moved back to Pennsylvania, we lived here. We lived in an RV. We lived in this one for half the time. We lived in a different one that we had before this for the other half of the time. And this was where we lived full time. Kelsey and I, we didn't have a baby at that time, so it was just the two of us. And my dreams were to live in an RV and travel around the world, like, you know. But we got halfway there. We bought the RV, and we didn't really do any traveling. But we learned a ton in that time that we lived in the RV, and it was one of the best experiences we ever had, because you realize how little you actually need, and some of the best years in our life were in this RV. And when we moved back from Arizona to Pennsylvania, we lived in it for about a year or more, right down the road at just like a KOA, a campsite. That's basically where we lived, and it was just an awesome opportunity. And once I accepted a full-time position at the church, we moved into the house. For like the last 2 years, we've been thinking about selling it because we just barely ever use it anymore. It sits in this storage unit, and it's a really big RV with lots of space, and we just don't have use for it anymore. We had to buy a pretty big RV because obviously it was what we lived in full-time, and so when you live in something full-time, you need some space. So it's got 3 slide outs, and it's like really big, and it's really fun to drive, and it's awesome to use. The problem with an RV is like what happens to so many people: you buy an RV and then you just don't travel as much as you want, and so it ends up just basically just costing you a lot of money to sit around. And so we're kind of definitely gonna be looking to sell it. So if you are interested in buying an RV, I would give you like a proper tour. The problem is that all the slides are in, so it's kind of pretty small right now and cramped. And so without the slides out, it doesn't really do much justice as far as how much room there actually is. And there's people next to us on both sides that we can't put the slides out, so you get the picture. But hopefully you understood. This is our RV. The bedroom's in there. And the, yeah. So that's who I am. I would love to know more about you. Where are you from? Tell me in the comments below where you're from and what you do. Let's just keep this conversation going. I planned on definitely getting to bed early today because that was the goal. I had barely any sleep, you know, that whole thing. So I was targeting 9, 9:30, something around there, but dang it.